Hello, welcome back. In this video, I want to show you my process on how I sew a functional jacket, an outdoor jacket for mountain hiking. And I want to do it out of this cloth here. That's a soft shell with a very bright color on the outer side. That is important in the mountains if you get in trouble, that you will be seen. And the inner side is laminated with some kind of fluffy cotton, so it's also good for insulation, a little bit warmer and a little bit thicker. I have made a similar jacket in the past, 2 years ago or something like that, out of the same cloth, but that time, you see it here, it was a jacket. And this time I want to do a vest, not a jacket. It should be very thin here. I had two layers, an inner layer and an outer layer. And that's always much easier to sew than if you have only one layer. And you have to think about how you will do that zipper here. And how you will do here on the neck part, the seams, but I think we will manage that. So this time the vest will be only one layer, only where the pockets are. We of course have two layers, but the rest will be one layer. And this jacket is a very tight fit. So I made the pattern as a very tight fit, and this is also a very tight fit because it's flexible, that's fine. But as I want to wear the vest over a jacket, this one or another one, normally I wear for mountain hiking, I wear a jersey jacket underneath and the vest over that jacket, it has to be wider. And to get more width in here, I will just take a stripe, I think 2 centimeters per side will be sufficient. Here a stripe is 2 centimeters and here, so I have 4 centimeters more width overall, and that should be sufficient in my opinion to make a good fit, tight enough, not too loose and not too tight. Yeah, so I think let's begin by taking the pattern and cutting. So this is my pattern. I constructed the pattern with Valentina. That's an open source pattern construction program. Very nice one. I really love it. There's also a fork called Seamly2D. That's fine as well, of course. If you start with pattern making, you can choose between those two. I started with Valentina because that was the original one, and therefore I'm a little bit stuck to it. It's a quite big pattern, and I recently made also raglan versions. I have kind of color code here now to get the right parts together for every version I need. And yeah, I will do that now. The back part. And that's it. Okay, one more thing. Of course, you need some zippers for the jacket. One zipper for the front. I've chosen a black one just because I don't have that color and I want to have a two-weight zipper here, so I have a black two-weight zipper. So I will use this one for the front, and for the pockets I have some waterproof zipper and fairly matching color, I would say. So I will use this zipper for the pockets. And for the inner side, for the zipper here, for the front one, I always like to have some, like, on my pullovers, to have some cloth in between, so it's nicer to wear. And I think I will use here also a black jersey for that. So we also have to cut the jersey. Yeah. Okay, let's start cutting. I have put some needles in here so the fabric won't shift, because I cut two layers as usual, so I have the same cut for every part. Yeah, let's start. Finished this part. Next I will cut the stripe for the front zipper out of the black jersey. I have to make a correction. I just saw that they delivered the wrong zipper, the other one I showed you before. I ordered a 80 centimeter long zipper and they delivered a 85 centimeter long zipper, so I can't use it. So I now took another one. I have also, this is a two-way zipper, 80 centimeter long, and also a waterproof one. So it will fit with this one. Both are waterproof, just a different color. And yeah, that will also do it. To save fabric, I now try to cut it here. And I have 88 centimeters here in length. That will be maybe sufficient. I'm not sure. Maybe not. We will see. But I tried. So now I will do the lining of the zipper, and as always I start with preparing here the upper part. Sewing it down like this. Now the zipper looks like this, and next is the lining. Therefore, I've halved it with the iron, ironed it down a little bit, and now I'm going to attach that. Now it looks like this, and then I go to the inner side and sew it down all the way to the bottom. As the jersey is elastic, it's always good to have the jersey on the lower side here while you're sewing. That is much easier because it will not stretch that much because it is directly driven by the transporter of the machine. Okay, here on the low end, I did the same like at the upper end, and now the first part looks like this. You see I did the sewing here at the outer edge of the zipper, because you don't want to see the seam afterwards if you put the main seam in the middle here, so it will just hide. Yeah, now the same for the second part. Again, here the first part, and now I will take it to the inner side and sew down as the first one. I know that zippers are intimidating for a lot of people, but in my opinion they aren't such hard to sew. It's just about doing the right thing. If you do it in the right way, it's not very difficult. So that's the top of the outer side. And the inner side looks like this. So you never touch the zipper parts. So you always have here a very soft jersey lining that's very cozy and convenient to wear. Okay, next is the zipper lining for the pocket zippers. The pockets from the outer side look like this. I want to have the zippers aligned that they are on the lower part of the pocket if they are closed, so this way. And this is the lining here. You have to look because it's not straight, so it will fit to the other two parts, that you do it correctly here. Use the right part for the right side, and then it's very easy. You have this one. Now we have this for one side and the other one for the other side. Same here, just don't have to be very precise because you will cut it afterwards. Just important to have the right parts to the right ends. Thank you. Okay, so let's begin. Just put this in the right direction. Because you turn it around afterwards, you have to put it the wrong way at the moment. And then I always do it like this. I changed the thread in the machine, the color of the thread from a black one to the right red pink one here. So it looks like this now. Also here, sew on the very edge, so you won't see the seam afterwards. And now that's done here. Okay, the same with the second zipper. Okay, zipper linings are ready. Next, we will sew the front parts of the pocket together. Okay, finish the first one. So it's a little bit tricky to get it aligned correctly. Didn't work out perfectly here, unfortunately. But it's not such bad that you would have it to redo it. For this outer seam here, I have a liner on my machine that is very convenient, so it looks very clear and precise. And now that's my look, how I do the all the functional thing, all with outer sewing lines. Okay, as you can see, the second one even got worse. I'm very lazy at aligning the parts correctly today, so the jacket will be some millimeters, more or less a centimeter shorter than expected. Yeah, but it is like it is. The outer seams here look nice, so next thing we have to do is to cut a piece of pocket fabric for the inner side and sew this onto the outer side so it can't slip if we then sew the upper and the lower part to the middle part here. So for the pocket fabric I use the black jersey again that I used for the lining of the zipper, the main zipper. I will cut it a little bit bigger than it has to be, just not to get in trouble while attaching the whole thing, because afterwards we will cut all the rest away so it looks nice and clean. Next thing is to just fix the pocket fabric to the soft shell so you have it, it's easier to sew it afterwards, the whole thing. sew on the very edge of the fabric, so it the seam will not be seen afterwards if I do the main seam. You can use really a big stitch length, that's makes really no difference. It's just for fixing it a little bit. Here you see where it makes sense to cut the fabric bigger than the outer one, than the soft shell, because both here are very elastic. Everything floats in every direction while sewing, and you get in a lot of trouble if you cut it precisely and then it's too small because the soft shell is expanding a little bit while sewing. And so if you do it this way, it's much easier. What you have to do here is to cut around now, so you have it in one part precisely cut. Okay, next I will iron both things a little bit so they will get straight again, hopefully. So this part didn't work out very well. We have still here the curve in. We will see how this will impact the look of the end product. So next thing is to sew the lower part to the pocket part here, and to have the front ready. So if you want to have a clean look on that, you should take an overlock machine and clean up the seam here. I forgot that before, so I had to open up the seam again I just made a few minutes ago. I did that on the second one already, then it looks like this, or like this from the other side, so that's of course much nicer than if you leave it this way. But in principle you don't have to, because those jersey fabrics are not prone to fiddling out here on the edge. Okay, done. So you see, it came out quite well. Looks clean on the inner side. I now do the same for the second part. I won't film it, don't want to bore you with just sewing videos with straight sewing seams. I will get back to you after that. Okay, so we are finished with the front parts. They came out nicely. Also the second one. Looks fine. I'll give you a close-up here. Lower to the upper part. Next, we will sew the front parts to the shoulder part here to be able to set in the next part. Next, we have to put the collar in place. That is always a bit fiddly, and we will see how it works out. Okay, came out quite well. Also looks kind of clean on the inner side. So we will now see the zipper. It's fitting here. Yeah. So from the top to the bottom, here we have some overlay for the lower seam. Yeah, fine. The next thing we will do is to prepare the zipper. So we will sew the stripes to the zipper. Yeah, so here I will try something I never did before, and I'm lining the zipper here with a ribbon. So we will see how that will work. Now the second part. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is to line the zipper here. Therefore, I will try this kind of folding device here. I prepared some stripes also out of the black jersey I used before. 5 centimeters wide. And now I will try to hold it in this way and sew all the way down so it's lined up and looks nice and clean. To prepare for this, I will just see how much length I will need and put some extra length in, maybe like this, and then I cut both ends so I will not sew too much. Okay, as I said, never did that before. Let's give it a try. Okay, let's see how this works out. I don't start at the real top because of the inner collar, and you won't see it on the top side here. Okay, I think first one worked out. I will show you in a moment. So let's do the second one. Okay, so now the second side. You may have seen that I have put a black thread into the machine. That's only because you won't see my curvy seam afterwards as much. So the result is fairly fine, I would say. I like it. looks good. So next we will make our standard seam here to free the zipper. And that's a lot of layers now. Hopefully that
will work. Okay, so let's try this seam.
Okay, now I will sew the second one. Okay, so we also got this done. I'll show you how it looks like. Like this now, top part. So the next thing is now to sew the zipper to the front so we can next finish the collar in the next step afterwards. So I did a mistake before. I just sewed both seams down without looking at the alignment. If you want to sew both here, then you want to have the horizontal seams here aligned afterwards. This one, and this one. And I didn't take care of that. And of course, as the material is elastic, if you don't take care of that, it's not aligned. So we have to redo it. And this time I will take care and take some measures, put some needles in here to be sure that everything is aligned and we will have a clean look afterwards. Also here we need six centimeters. It works out, and we will take care that this will work. Okay, now it should work. What I always like to do is to have a short seam here in every place with the normal sewing machine to fix that before I go over with the overlock. Just fixing the seams a bit. Okay, see how it worked out this time. Yeah, much better. This is fine now. We have a good alignment here and here. So, this looks good now. Okay, so let's finish it. Put in the main seam and then the outer seam. The next thing is that we will put the collar liner on here. To be able to do that, we will also take one of these stripes and line the downside here so that we afterwards are able, I think, to hand sew it down here or something like that. We will see. Lining the collar. Okay, so now sewing the collar on. Well, next task is now to sew this one on. Also on the other side, and then sew it down like this so it will look nicely here. I think that has to be done by hand. It's always nice to have some kind of handmade part in there, so it's getting very personal, the whole vest. I won't film that because I won't bore you with some hand sewing that takes a long time. I'll show you the result afterwards. So as you can see, I sewed the collar down here by hand And yeah, I'm very satisfied with the result. It looks nice and clean. Next I will put a seam up here so the whole collar will look nice and clean afterwards. I don't show the process. I think you have seen enough sewing now, so I'll be back in a minute. Okay, I'm back. Did the seam. Oh. And as you can see, looks nice and clean from each side, so it's very satisfied with that. And next we will take our back part here and sew it to the assembly like this. Again, I will just do it and show you the result. Okay, back seam finished. So now we are going to close the side seams. And we're getting nearer and nearer to finish this project. Side seams finished. As you can see, they came out nicely. That's the inside. Nice and clean. Also the other one. So now there's not much left to do. You need to take care here of the arm opening and the lining of this here. I think I will use again the black jersey stripes for both with the folding device and try that, because that looks nice and it's not very complicated, and I don't need any other machine, so, and it's very thin, so it doesn't pick up too much thickness here in both cases. Yeah, let's see how that works. Okay, let's try it. So I have again put in a black thread into the machine, of course, and I will try doing a good seam, nice looking seam. Let's see how it works. Okay, so the first one went not too bad, I would say. Came out nice, at least from the outside. From the inside there are some flaws. It's not, you know, if you don't have the proper equipment and everything well adjusted, it's always that you see it, that it's handmade. So we now sew the second arm opening.
Okay, so we got it. The first one worked quite well, as you can see. Oh no, that's the second one. Here, it didn't work so good. I will sew that down by hand. But the other one, I'm satisfied with the other one. That's okay. So the last thing is that we do this here. Let's see how that will work out, because I have to make a nice folding finish at the beginning and at the end. We'll see. So let's see how the last seam will work out. Okay, that worked well. So, yeah, I'm quite satisfied. Last thing I want to do is to add some zipper pulls here for all the zippers. So it's easier, because I go mountain hiking with that, and in winter time you have gloves on, and it's easier to grab if you have a zipper pull on that. That's the last thing I will show you. So for the zipper pulls, there are a lot of YouTube videos out there. I'll show you how I do it. It's quite easy. You start with a kind of special knot, and always take the lighter. You need a lighter for the cord here, and some cord, some plastic cord of course, otherwise it won't work with the lighter. And then you add as many knots as you want. I always make 6. 3, 4, 5, 6, and it looks like this. And to finish it, you need some sharp scissor. Cut it so there's not much left here, and then take the igniter, carefully melt it, and then I use always the scissors to press it in so it will not come out anymore. Yeah, and then looks like this. And it's very convenient. So I'll do this for the other 3 zipper pulls here, and then we are finished. Okay, finished. So I'm fairly satisfied with the outcome. It looks nice. Here you can see the zipper pulls. The other one's on the pocket. I like it. So, thanks for watching and stay tuned. I think you will see this vest in action in one of my next mountain hiking videos, I would say. So, yeah, take care.